Hey guys, it's Lego Maestro here, and welcome back to another episode of Hypixel Alert. And this one is going to be the final episode covering the Technoblade versus Dream $100,000 duel. So I hope you guys are excited for that, and along with that, of course, as you can see, this is an episode that is in-game. So let me know what you guys think of this as opposed to normal Skywars gameplay. And you guys, before this episode gets started, I wanted to give a quick shout-out to my good friend O'Cloudies. If you guys haven't heard of his YouTube channel, he currently has over 26,000 subscribers. I highly recommend checking him out. His link is in the description. He makes some pretty good content, and he's also done some coverage on this Technoblade versus Dream $100,000 duel. So I hope you guys will check him out. His link will be the first one in the description. But with that, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to get into the news. We've got a lot to get into this week, so let's get started. Now, last episode we left off on Thursday, the day this historic duel went down, and along with this, we also had some predictions on the official 1v1 video coming out this weekend. And well, 2 days later, you guys already know, on Saturday, August 29th, MrBeast officially released the video. Now, one thing to note is that almost the exact time that this video premiered, both Technoblade and Dream tweeted out at the same time saying, GG! Now, this video that MrBeast released was an absolutely huge event with over 300,000 concurrent viewers. I mean, it's not as many live viewers as K-pop gets, but it's still a really huge deal. Now, in order to cover this next point, I'm going to do something I have never done once on Hypixel Alert. I'm going to show a clip from a previous episode, and this one is going to be from a couple episodes ago when I talked about the Dream versus Technoblade duel, where I had some inside info. We have some exclusive info about the event from an anonymous, credible source that's near the action. Now, this is not confirmed, but they say that this is the 1.16 kit that is going to be used. It's going to include full diamond armor, a shield, a diamond sword and axe, a crossbow, bow, and 5 arrows. And for the 1.8 PvP, the kit includes a full set of diamond armor, a diamond sword, a rod, bow, and 5 arrows. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the video came out this weekend, and they turned out to be the exact kits used in the event, down to the 5 arrows. So if you guys cannot tell by now, this is the only place to get exclusive info on what's going on. So if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe and maybe turn on those notifications. That's up to you. But I highly, highly recommend it because, as you guys can tell, I'll make sure to keep you informed on everything going on with this story and the Hypixel Network. Now, if you guys have not seen the video, it was absolutely awesome. Of course, the link is in the description if you haven't watched it already. But, as you can expect, the winner, ladies and gentlemen, as predicted from the last episode of Hypixel Alert, was Technoblade. Now, in the previous episode of the news, the prediction that I covered had a guess of Techno winning 7-3, and in the video, he won 6-4, so it was pretty close. Now, after this video came out and Technoblade was proven to be the winner, there were 3 different hashtags about this event that were trending on Twitter. Technoblade never dies, dual spoilers, and blood for the blood god. All 3 of these were trending, and by now, if you guys can't tell, this duel was absolutely huge. Now, after this, Squid Kid actually responded to Technoblade's GG, saying, "Let's go! I knew you could do it!" Which, I've gotta say, is pretty heartwarming. Squid Kid and Techno, they've had their differences, but you can tell that Squid was rooting for Techno the entire time, which, I mean, that kind of melts your heart. That's just such a cool thing to see. And also, along with this, he tweeted out, saying, "Now you understand my pain of losing to the blood god, at Dream was taken, GG." Now, after the video was released, Dream tweeted out, saying, "Love you, Techno, no beef between us, only pork." And to this, Simon officially responded, saying, "2 years ago, Technoblade destroyed me in duels, and I haven't mentally and physically recovered. I get weekly recommendations from YouTube to watch it again and again, and it's time we unite for revenge." Now, that could just be a joke, but it looks like Simon could be reaching out to Dream here to hopefully do some kind of thing against Techno, maybe even a manhunt. I have no idea. That's obviously pure speculation. Now, you guys, before MrBeast's video was even uploaded, there was some talk going around about who was going to make an analysis video of the tournament, because naturally whoever makes that video would get a ton of views because everyone is looking for it, right? Who's gonna break down the fights, talk about what went down, how they could have played better, what they did wrong, that type of thing. And ladies and gentlemen, none other than Technoblade decided he would be the one to do it, because later that day he made a video titled "Dream versus Technoblade $100,000 duel analysis." Yup, Techno took the video for himself. I mean, he's no dummy. And I mean, it's just as you would guess if you haven't already seen the video. He analyze the fight and his side of things. It's pretty entertaining to see his thought process, so I do recommend it if you have not seen it yet. Now, of course, once Technoblade released this video, he made a tweet saying, "Did an analysis of the $100,000 duel, new video." And to this, Simon responded, saying, "Did you open the mystery box I sent you months ago? There is a Minecraft PvP guide inside." Which, by the way, guys, I think we're close to a year now since he sent him that chest. And well, to this, Dream responded, saying, "Can you please send me it?" And Simon responded, saying, "I'm afraid Techno is now the only one in possession of the sacred book. And I must confess, I signed it and bundled it with a pig mask. It might have created some voodoo magic in the process." So thanks to Simon, for the first time ever, we now actually know something that is in this chest, which includes a signed PvP book and a pig mask. Now, along with this, on the day of the duel, I tweeted out, and this is not just to self-promote my Twitter, okay? Just keep watching. I tweeted out saying, "If there was ever a time for Simon to give Technoblade another plus to his rank, this would be the day." And to this, Simon, after getting tagged probably 1,000 times, responded saying, "If I were to give a plus for all the victories, the entire chat would be filled with pluses." And to this, famous organizer PikaClix responded, saying, "I don't know, bro. It's a big one, and I think a fourth plus is fair." And to this, Simon responded saying, "I have other plans." So ladies and gentlemen, that is completely up for debate, whatever this is. In fact, I even reached out to Simon trying to get any clue on this, any statement for the news, and he said it's a secret, like he won't even tell me, okay? I sadly have no exclusive info here, you guys, so let me know what you think it is in the comments below. Honestly, it could be a custom rank, it could be find the button implemented as a minigame into Hypixel. Like, we really have no idea. I mean, at least I don't. Maybe you guys have a clue, and if you do, let me know in the comments below. And lastly, you guys, to finish off this story of this historic $100,000 duel, Dream also uploaded a video on it on Saturday, the day that Mr. Beast released, and he basically showed the 18-minute Discord call that took place after the end of the duel. Now, at the very end of the video, he put on screen for just a few seconds that both he and Technoblade split the money, which I've gotta say is really, really cool. Honestly, $100,000 is no small amount, and obviously, the whole point of this duel was to see who would win in the fight, and obviously $100,000 would go to the winner, but it does make for a much better story if they split the money, which is exactly what happened. Now, I saw a comment saying that the idea to split the money was decided before it had even begun, before this duel had gone down, but honestly, no matter what happened, it's really, really cool to see, and of course, big congratulations to Dream and Techno on this fight. And the very, very last thing on this story, I know, I said there was like one last thing, and this is the next last thing, but you guys, Mr. Beast, Technoblade, and Dream all wanted people to know that there is no beef between them, okay?
I'm glad you guys both can still be friends, and I think we should express to the viewers that, like, this was for fun.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
No beef.
It's totally fine if you want to have a favorite in the duel and even be sad about it, but the main thing to remember is that none of us should be spreading hate in any way. At the end of the day, this is a fun Minecraft duel between two awesome creators, and Mr. Beast wants to highlight that. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to do it for the news this week. I truly hope you've enjoyed it. Once again, O'Cloudy's channel will be in the description if you want to check him out. I do highly recommend it. It's once again the first link, and of course, if you guys want to stay up to date on everything going on in Hypixel, I was about to say this $100,000 duel, but I guess with this episode, there is no more to say about it. It's over, you guys. The duel that everyone was hyped about, the duel that happened, the $100,000, everything has finally gone down. Now, whether Dream and Technoblade will do more stuff in the future, I have no doubt. In fact, in Dream's video, they even talked about Manhunt, so maybe that'll happen in the future. But of course, we'll just have to wait and see. Guys, have a truly blessed day. Thank you so much for watching this episode of the news. Hypixel Alert, now over 109,000 subscribers. And I will see you next time.